Hi everyone! Welcome to AgaveCornerFamily.com! We're really glad you decided to join us today. We have a great lineup for y'all. Well, let's go to Nick for some of the events that happened here at AgaveCornerFamily.com.
We had the greatest time. The singles from the Bridge Church were not here for Easter. They provided us with all kinds of food and treats. They even had an Easter egg hunt. We're going to roll some footage of our Easter egg club.
Kaylin, what has been going on here at ACF.com? The wind is blowing and the boys are acting crazy. Let's go to ACF.com field. Let's roll the footage.
He'll be right out. Woman overboard! Woman overboard!
Miguel is out of his boat.
And they're off and running. And you see Kaylin, and then there comes Johnny, and they're going, 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 and they're off!
Yeah! All righty! That is perfect!
Man, that beats watching TV! Hey Nick, who's in our spotlight interview this month?
We'd like to introduce you all to Miss Anna. Miss Anna? She's our new staff member at Agape Corner. Miss Anna, do you mind if I ask you a few questions?
No, not at all.
How did you find about Agape Corner Ministries?
I found out through one of the board members who is related to my aunt.
Very good. What is your favorite color?
Purple.
All right. What is your favorite food?
Any type of Italian food. My favorite. Pasta, pizza, that type of stuff.
Oh, buon appetito. You like sports?
I love sports.
What kind?
Soccer is my favorite sport, then basketball, then the rest all kind of fall in line together. Those are my main two sports.
Man, you are so cool. Well, thanks for your time. From all of us here at ACF.com, we'll see you later. Back to you, Caitlin.
Thanks, Miss Anna, for joining us today. We'd like to go to the Bridge Church and the Holy Smoke Barbecue, where Amanda is standing by to bite into some awesome food. Amanda, are we smoking yet?
I see smoking chicken, pork, and ribs.
Smoking chicken, pork, and ribs!
Let's talk to a few people and ask them how they like their Holy Smoke Barbecue. My name is Amanda.
And my name is Donnie.
My name is Jack.
Can we ask you a few questions?
Yes. Gladly.
How does your barbecue taste?
Oh, it's wonderful. It's wonderful.
Do you come here often?
This is our first time.
Did you know that the money that the Holy Smoke Barbecue makes goes to supporting children?
Yes, I do know.
Hi, my name is Amanda.
Hi, Amanda. How are you? My name's Kenny.
Can we ask you a few questions?
I would love it.
How does your barbecue
My barbecue is wonderful. This is even better.
Do you come here often?
Yes, I do. I try to come here at least once a week.
Did you know that the money that the host is worth to make to his treasure? Yes,
well, that's all the time we have. Back to you, Caitlin. I think I will stick around a while and eat some ribs.
Thanks, Amanda. Don't eat too much. Well, we have come to the place in our video where we'll be sharing a story about our future. Yes, we have to stop and think. Where is our future going? So ACF.com proudly presents part two, the story of our future, change or not.
Our future. Last month, we saw two people make some very bad decisions in their life, and because of this, we see the consequences of their action. Four homeless kids. The state doesn't want them, and the world would rather they'd be someplace else. Let's see where they are now and how they're being treated. Homeless, cold, hungry, and thirsty. Nowhere to go. Look, it's our future. 8 years later, Children's Services tried to place them, but nobody could take four children into their home. The children run away. They find comfort in this alley. Look into their eyes. These children are your children. These children are our future. No pillow. No blanket. This young girl reaches into a garbage can for just a little morsel of food. This young man says, "I'll look over here. I'll find something for us to eat." But there was nothing to eat. Alone, scared, not certain of their future. These children's parents made a bad choice. And this choice brought these children to this alley. This man offers them some bread as a comfort to his own conscience. He doesn't bring them into his home and allow them to become part of his family, but gives them a band-aid to a mighty, mighty, mighty large wound that these children have. Look into their eyes and recognize these children are our future.